English shorthand dictation 80 words per minute December 2012. Yes, get ready, start. Gentlemen, in all the four addresses which you have presented to me, you have expressed your loyalty to the King Emperor, and I must begin by thanking you for these expressions. You have used some very kind words of welcome to my wife and myself, for which we are both very grateful. As you have been kind enough to acknowledge, I have strong personal interest in the welfare of India, partly because it is the land of my birth, and partly because I have spent more than 2 years in the Indian office. There I acquired not only some knowledge of Indian problems, but a sympathy with the political aspirations of the Indian people. I therefore approach the problems which you have laid before me today with a full measure of interest and goodwill. From the several petitions which reach me from different parts of the province, there seems to be an idea that government possesses unlimited power and unlimited wealth. In fact, however, our financial resources are by no means equal to our needs, and even such money as we possess has to be taken from the pockets of the people for whose benefit it is spent. Every demand for financial assistance from the government would mean increased taxation, the burden of which would have to be shared by the people who make the request. Both the resources and the powers of government are restricted. I shall represent your needs to my colleagues, and they in turn will have to represent them to the Legislative Council, whose consent is required to the expenditure involved. First, there is the case of water supply. Here I am glad to learn that water works system is in existence, towards the cost of which the government makes a regular grant. The problem of rural water supply referred to by the district board is a local problem which will have to be solved locally. Government can help with expert advice, but they cannot provide grants for such a purpose. I am extremely sorry to hear of the financial condition of the local dispensary, but government would not be justified in paying the salary of the assistant surgeon in charge. Let me now turn to the question of education. Education, as you know, is now a transferred subject. It is therefore under the control of the minister and the Legislative Council. My government has not yet decided to purpose legislation for the establishment of free and compulsory education throughout the province. For this year, they have decided to introduce as an experiment a new scheme of primary education in certain areas. The education will not be altogether free, but the authorities will be authorized to levy fees on only half of the students in their schools. The cost will be shared equally between the government and the local authorities. If you accept this offer and cooperate with the government, you will be able to make a substantial beginning in the improvement of primary education within the district. With regard to your technical school, I am glad to hear that you are satisfied with the work it has been doing. In conclusion, allow me to thank you once more for your very kind and warm welcome, to assure you of the great pleasure which it gives to us to become personally acquainted with your local problems. Dear sirs, you are no doubt aware that for a number of years I have acted as the sole agent for your goods in this country, and you have on several occasions been pleased to express your thanks for the services I have been able to render. Today, I am not meeting with the same measure of success as in previous years, and I venture to put before you one or two points for your consideration. In the first place, fixed prices and prompt delivery are essential if I am to maintain my reputation as a salesman of British goods. In view of competition from Germany and Japan, although there is nothing to fear from the quality of our goods, there must be no delay in the delivery of orders, and our customers must not be tempted by low prices quoted by other countries to place order elsewhere. In the second place, I must draw your attention to the harm done to your trade by publishing catalogues in English and prices in sterling. Many customers do not know English, and these catalogues are almost useless to them, and it becomes necessary for me to spend much time in describing the goods. This information will be given in your advertisements, printed in our customers' language, and my time could then be devoted to securing new business. May I ask you to give these matters your immediate attention. Yours faithfully.